My name is Travis Morales with Refuse Fascism here in New York. And this morning I was sent a statement to read here from progressive Iranians in New York and New Jersey. So listen up to what our brothers and sisters in progressive Iranians have to say. A very quick look at the political picture of this country today. All the signs point to a massive storm gathering as people are breaking away from the order that has been created by one of the ruthless ruling classes dominating this country. It was just reported that 19,000 Amazon workers were sacrificed for one of the profit-making machinery that doesn't make any product. Kids and youth are sent to schools without any adequate preparation. Healthcare workers are forced to care for others while the danger of the spread of COVID-19 virus is ignored. Thousands of black youths are terrorized on a daily basis just because of the color of their skin. The political, social, and economic problems under the capitalist system are not anything new. What's new is that the ruling class cannot accept any changes that question its authority and its grip on people's lives. At the same time, since they don't have any solution for the crisis they are facing, they choose to resort to fascism. The most backward elements of the society are being rallied to maintain the status quo and impose outright fascism. Ultranationalism and make America great notion are nothing but recalling the superiority of the white race and taking the clock back. It is not acceptable to the ruling class how strong, for example, the struggle for women's rights has become. They cannot see millions are against anti-immigrant policies and practices. They cannot go along with students standing up against the ultra-right groups. They are frightened to death when they see the outrage of millions when their boys murder in cold blood the innocent young blacks. As Iranians, we have experienced the same rise to fascism right after when the monarchy was overthrown and the religious Ayatollahs took power. Their attacks on universities, women, workers, minorities, media, artists, and writers led to on-the-spot killings in the streets and mass murder of over 5,000 political prisoners in 2 months in 1988. We have learned two important lessons. One, unity is the key in defeating the fascism. No one can fight fascism alone. Supporting the cause of the ruling class unites itself under the banner of fascism. The progressive forces need to be united as well. Two, the struggle against fascism needs the leadership, the type of leadership that has both political and organizational experience and foresight. And their last words, your struggle and fight against fascism and for justice have far greater impact, and it is recognized by all freedom fighters around the world. Fighting against the American and the Iranian fascists is one single fight. We are with you at every step of the way. Fascism, as it has been proven throughout history, will be defeated, but not on its own or without the efforts and fights of you and all anti-fascists, from the progressive Iranians in New York and New Jersey.